Hey guys, Stephanie here. So this is another jewelry making video. I'm going to be using some of the Tim Holtz assemblage pieces and we're going to be making a bracelet. Now I have very limited supplies of the assemblage pieces. So I wanted to just put something together to show you that even if you have something, some limited amount of stuff, you can still make something really, really cool and gorgeous. Okay. So I was digging through my stash and y'all know I got a pretty big stash. Well, not as big as some, I guess, but you know. I have a lot of stuff, but I didn't have a lot of the assemblage pieces, you know, and some of it, most, a lot of it, I got just duplicates. So I was like, well, okay, well, what are we going to do with that? I love these that I got on clearance. These are beautiful. So we love those. So I'll probably use those. And then I got this chain, this really dark, kind of dark silver chain. And I thought it'd be really cool to make a bracelet with. Okay. And then of course I dug through my stash and I found some lobster claws closures. Okay. So we got that. And then I have some jump rings. Okay, so I have, let me see what I got in here. I have 6mm, a few of those, and I have 8mm. So we're going to have to make this work. Okay, so again, limited supplies, and we're going to make something fabulous. When I make the bracelet, I have an idea to hang some dangles off of it, so I will have to dig in my stash for those. But again, this is going to be minimal, okay? So now I'll pull these out. I don't know if I'll use these, but those are kind of cool, so... And you can sort of mix and match your pieces. Now, most of this I'll be using as assemblage, but again, you can mix and match your pieces to make whatever it is you want, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and get started on our project, pull out all your stuff, and come on and create with me.
All right, guys, so I am going to start with this chain. I'm going to take just a link of this off. I'm going to take this side off.
And I'm going to see how long it is. It might be too long, so I have to take a few links out, you know? And then we could save the other piece for some other projects, okay? So let's go ahead and take this off. Just unhook it like that. I'm going to close it back for now because I'm not sure, you know, what I'm going to add into this. So I think I'm going to just stop, take it off here. And if we need it longer, we'll just get another link, okay? So let's just do that. So that is the piece that we took off and let's measure it here. Okay. Now I'm doing the kind of old school here. So I have a bead board and all that, but I have two bead boards in here in this room and they both have beads on them. So, yeah, now this is 7.5 inches. Okay. Which might be a tad too long, but what I might do is when I close it up, I'll just have an extra link for some dangles. So instead of linking it like at the end, I can link it up in here to make the bracelet with the closure. And then we could have something hanging off of there, which I think will be very cute. Okay. So we will save this for another day. Now I love these. Let's see. Let's cut these off of here. All right. This is how I cut them off. All right. Let's cut these off. We don't know if we're going to use these or not. We'll keep them handy, though. We might. So, let's see. I'm thinking, hold on, let's look at the bracelet. Well, I don't know. I might need another link because I'm realizing, because if I make it for myself, I'm a 7-inch wrist. So, I might need another link. Oh, yeah, y'all. I'm going to need another link. Here, I'll use these. Because we definitely want some dangles, right? We want a few dangles. At least I do. Let me see. Yeah, here. I will take this piece, these two, and take those off of there. Okay, and then we will add these to the link. So you can measure however you want, how big or small your wrist is, or for whomever you're making it for, if you're making it to sell it. You can do that. Now, let's see. Let's try that. Okay, yeah, now that's great. That gives me a lot more space with the dangle there. And then once I close it, it'll have that little piece hanging. I know you can't see because of my hand. See that? There you go. All right, now let's measure that. See how much that is. It's probably 8. Yeah, it's just about 8 inches. Let's measure. Hold on, let's straighten it out. Measure, measure. Measure, measure, a little over 8 inches. Yeah, a little over, just a tad over 8 inches. Like 8 and 8, I don't know.
not quite 8 1/4, but a little less than that. Okay. So we like our fit. We like the way it fits. Now let's do our design, because that's going to be the issue. How we want to design it, because we have such limited pieces, like, you know.
Okay, guys, so I have had a change of plan. I don't think I will use these because they are a little bit big and they would space out my pieces too much. And I really want these to be the focal. You know, these two gorgeous pieces here. Look how pretty these are, right? So if I did like that, it'll just be too, like, you see them on the side, and I don't want that. So I will save that for another project because I have another idea. I always have tons of ideas, but, you know, no time to execute anything. So I've been sitting here playing with it, and I think this is how I want it to look. I think I'm going to use another one of these, and I'm going to just kind of, so I'd have to break up the links to add these, because these are connector pieces, and I would have to break up the links to add the pieces, you know. And of course, you know, we will save the extra pieces in the chain to use with other things, to use, you know, put them back on there. So save all your pieces. And I'm just laying them out like this. And then here's my closure. So that's going to look cool. A nice, cute, easy, beautiful bracelet, right? Something very simple, but very cool and elegant that will work for us. Okay. Like, really cool. This black is really pretty. And I have some other charms I would have to dig out that I think will look very cool on there. Like, look at that. That's pretty. Look at that. So cute. I love. Okay. We're going to put this together because I really like this, but I think it's too big. Yeah, I think it's too big. We'll save it, though. I will save it for some other things. All right. So now let me figure out my layout here with my links as I break this up. And then we will attach our pieces, and then we will close it off with our closure and our dangles, guys, and we will be done. See? Quick and easy. I love a quick, easy jewelry, little jewelry project, right? All right. You know, we like to switch things up on this channel. Sometimes I work on my journals. Sometimes I do art, mixed media art. And sometimes I love to make fabulous jewelry. That's my sort of my first love. All right. Okay, guys. So what I did was I just broke up the links. And I just kind of counted out how many, you know, I would need between each connector. And it looks like 3. And I kind of measured it. But, you know, because after we add our closure on here, that's going to give us a little bit more length. And then I might just put one at the end here and just kind of have it like that. And I definitely want a few, you know, on the end so like they can dangle off, right? I'm not sure if I'm going to do it on this end or this end, but... So that's what I came up with so far, and I think it looks pretty good. But, you know, when I put it together, we will, you know, put it on and see how we like it, and we can adjust from there, okay? So I'm going to save these pieces. This is nice, nice chain. So I'm going to save all these pieces, okay? And I'm just going to connect all of this together here. Let's move that out of the way. And I wanted to do off camera in case it took me too long. So, you know, sometimes putting it together kind of takes a while. So I did that. Just open those up and close them back. Sometimes some of the chains are very hard to close up because they're so tough. Okay, so we like that. We love. Okay, I'm sorry, y'all. Let me get in the camera so y'all can see. Yeah, let's see. Okay. And you can always watch this in full screen to get, you know, to see exactly what I'm doing. So if you're a new jewelry maker, wait, hold on, y'all, just a second. If you are a new jewelry maker, you can, you know, kind of see up close what I'm doing here. All right. All right. So let's do this. Open that up. And what I'm going to just do is connect these two pieces here. I'm just using the pieces that it came with. I'm going to connect that. Oh, no. Sorry. Wait a second. Wait, why do I only have 2? Oh, no. Hold on, y'all. Just a second. Let me see here. Okay. All right, so yeah, I'm connecting this one. And that's what we're going to do. Now, these will make really fabulous earrings, too, guys. Like, you can wear that as an earring, too. Just think about it. Have some dangles hanging from that. That would be pretty. Very pretty. We will see what else I can come up with. I have a few more pieces, y'all. We will see.
All right, now we have that. See, that's the way that that's going to look. Okay, very cool. Now we're just going to attach this piece. So you know what I'm going to do? Just open this jump ring and just attach it like that. I'm going to keep the jump rings on there for now. If it gets to be too long or looks too weird, doesn't lay right, I will go through and I just take out the jump rings, okay? So that's what we're going to do with that. And just close that up. Sometimes it works better with the jump rings, and sometimes it just you can just slide the link in the loop there. Okay, so let's close that up. Very pretty. All right, so far that's what we got. Very, very pretty. And then we will just connect our chain here. And this is a pretty simple project as well. Simple, easy jewelry project. Use what we have. Okay, we're closing that up. Make sure it's closed so it doesn't come apart. Oh, that's so pretty. I love it. And then we're going to have that, attach that one. These connector pieces are really cute. Really cute. I might have to go and see if I can find some more, because I would love to make some earrings. Have a nice little set, a necklace, a bracelet, and some earrings. That would be cute. Okay. Oh, I love. Let's see. Now, let's see. Let's test it, y'all. Let's give it a test drive. How do we like it? Oh, let's see. That's so pretty. Look at that. Oh, yeah. And, you know, it will probably move around the wrist a little bit. So I'm going to have to probably put a few more links. Oh, but I love that. So if it moves around the wrist at any point, it's still cute, you know? So we're going to add some more links, because I think adding a few more links would be good. Maybe three. Because we don't want it too long, but we want to have some little bit of room to add some dangles. Okay. Now I could have just opened the jump ring, y'all. Making our life harder for myself. Okay, so you just rock it back and forth to make sure it's closed, the link there, just like a jump ring. And this jump ring is not closed, so let's close that one. Okay. Yep, it's closed. Okay. There we go. That's so pretty. Oh my goodness. Isn't it gorgeous? Y'all, don't mind my ring. It doesn't really go with my ring. But look at how cute. Look at how cute. Don't we love? And then look at that. It has a little bit of room for some dangles. I love it. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to attach my jump ring. I'm going to attach my lobster claw. And I think I'm going to use, Let's see. Let's pull out a 6mm. And then let's pull out an 8mm and see what looks best. Probably the 6, maybe. And then these are just regular. They're not heavy gauge. But they go perfectly with the piece, which I love. I think I'm going to do 6. Let's try 6. All right, let's see. I think I'm going to do it like this. And what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to just put it here. All right. All right, and let's see. Oh, yeah. So if we wear it, we can put it in any of these to fit us, right? So you can always add more links on here for the extender pieces. Look at that. And I love that. I might add another link. I might add another link to that just to have. Oh, wait. No, I got 2 now. Well, we'll see. Although, that would be cute, too. Putting links on there. Let me see. Let's try it on. I might move one of these links over. But let's try it on. All right. So I'm going to have to take a couple of links out. I just want to try it. But yeah, I'm going to have to take a couple of the links out. Okay. But that's how it looks. So what I'm going to do is probably move. Just have one over here on this side, okay? And then move one of these over here and then take this one out. So that's what I'm going to do. Because I realize sometimes you have to try things on to see how they work, you know? So let's do that. So let's take this off. We're going to move this over. so we can have our dangle. All right, let's have put an extra one there for our dangles, which will be cute. Got some sparkly dangles to add. And then what we're going to do is take one of these off. Okay, and then just add, just have the one on there. Okay. And then we will try it on to see. All right, let's see. Yeah, locked up. Okay, there we go. I like that better, I think. All right, now look at that. That is so beautiful, guys. Such a pretty piece. Very cool and elegant, but dark and sexy. It's like all the above. All right, I like the way it fits now. Okay, so I can, you know, you have your extender pieces there. Feels if you want to make it longer or shorter. And then you have your pieces. You can lock it in there and have your dangles. Wait, can you see it? There we go. Okay. I can't see it. Hold on. So guys, that's how it looks. It's so pretty with the dangle there. All right. Very, very pretty. So we're going to hang a few pieces off of there. But yeah, let me go. I'm going to dig in my stash and find some pieces. And guys, we will be done with this project. It's so pretty. It's so beautiful. I'm so glad I decided to do this. Really, really beautiful. And easy. Okay. Very easy. So I think I might take this link out though. Let me see. I kind of like having it there. What I might do is take the jump ring out, y'all. And just attach it to the link. That'll shorten it just a little bit. Okay. So if you want to do that, you can do that. Just attach your jump ring like that. And be done, you know. And let's see, because you know, if it's for you, you want the fit to be right. Oh yeah, see, now that's much better. Oh, that's so pretty. Oh wait, you know what, guys, go look, it goes with my ring here. Look, let's put my other ring on. Let's put my other ring on. There we go. Yes, that works, right? That's so cute. Look at that. You look good coming, you look good going. Oh, that's so pretty. And you can layer this with some other stuff. You can layer this with some of your beaded bracelets. You can layer this with your memory wire bracelets. You can layer this with some of your charm bracelets, guys. Oh, honey, this is cute. This is so cute. So we're going to save all these little pieces here because we're going to try to make something else with this piece. So we need all these little pieces, okay? So let me go dig through the stash, find some really good... Let me find some great little charms to put on here. So we have some dangles. And then I will show you how you layer it as well. So we'll add that on at the end, okay? All right. Okay, guys. So I dug out a few charms. And I think I'm just going to put a couple of them on there, like this one. And then I really like this one, these two. Because I think it'll flow better with the piece. So I'm just going to put these on here. Now, the foundation of this bracelet is the assemblage Tim Holtz pieces. However, like I mentioned earlier, you will probably have to add some additional items to your makes because the line is very limited in what they have. So I'm just adding some other charms from other brands, okay? But the foundation is all the Tim Holtz stuff. So let me go ahead and put these on here. Let's see how they hang. I think I want it. I don't know. Let's see. I don't know. Let's see, y'all. What do we think? Maybe one here, one on the second one, and then one on the last one, or maybe both. I don't know. We'll see. Just put a jump ring on here, 6mm. This is heavy gauge jump rings, by the way. That's what these are, 6mm heavy gauge jump rings. I don't know if you can even see that, but let's see. Let's see here. There you go. Now, let's see how we like this other piece. What are we going to put that one? Maybe on the last. Maybe put this one on the last one. Kind of like that. All right, just use another jump ring. And we're just going to add it to that. And then I will show you a little bit of layering. Just a little bit. To give you an idea of how you may want to wear it. Because it is... you know, because of the rhinestones, it can have a lot going on already. So on its own, it's really a nice piece. But for ladies like me who like to layer their bracelets, so, you know, layering, keep your layering to a minimum, but you never know. Because, see, I tend to like layered pieces regardless of how sort of over the top they are. That's just how I wear my stuff. But this piece stands alone on its own just nicely. So it's pretty much finished here. And yeah, so let's try to put it on. Okay. All right, look at it. It's beautiful. Look at that. It is stunning. Stunningly beautiful. That is so pretty. So you can, you know, adjust it however you want. So if you have a bigger wrist, you can just put it in the second link and so on, you know. And I like to have just a little room. I like for it to hang a little bit. Kind of like that, okay? So it looks great with my ring, too. A little gothic, but still very beautiful. You know, a little edgy. You know, I think so. So, kind of mixed media. Got a little mixed media vibe to it. So, yeah, we like that. All right. Just want to show you the charms there on my wrist. Very, very pretty. Very pretty. So, and then if it should turn this way, you can rock it like that. Look how cute. Okay. So now we finished with the bracelet. It's gorgeous. Now here is one of my beaded bracelets. I did this in a video. Okay. And I will link that video probably at the end here, or at the very least, I will put it down in the description so you can check it out. Okay. So let's go ahead and try this on, but I kind of want this on the back end of it, because it's kind of a lot. Now that's like a lot going on, but I think that's beautiful. Like on a night on the town, like all these are gorgeous. And of course, yes, I made all these. I made the ring and I made both of the bracelets, obviously. But look at that. That is such a pretty, pretty piece, right? Now I have a couple of other bracelets here. And because like this, like I said, this is a lot, you could put in like a bangle. You could, but I think it would kind of take away from the piece. You can put it like, I would put it back here. Okay, hold on. Yeah, see, I would put it back there. There we go. That's a nice stack. And then this is a little memory wire piece. I don't know. I didn't, when I made this, it didn't come out the way I wanted it to. So I just kept it. So I'd use it just for layering, but you know, you get the idea. So you see, that's a nice little stack there. Couldn't wear all this. You can wear all this together if you want it, or, you know, wear it separately, but it's a nice, juicy, beautiful stack, right? Great for layering. So it's, you know, you can, layer these however you like. If it was me, I would just put this in the front. I'd probably just wear these two, honestly. But if I were feeling fancy free, I'd rock all these and have a beautiful stack of bracelets. Okay. But we love our bracelet. That's a wine themed bracelet, by the way, the bangle. Yeah. So very pretty. Came out gorgeous. So even if it's hanging like this way, it's beautiful. Look at that. Very unique and very, very pretty. So, all right, guys. Well, I thank you guys for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them below and I'll answer them and get back to you. And let me know how you like the bracelet, okay? So definitely give me a follow on my social media platforms. I am Stephanie Garrett Creative on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And I am Stephanie Garrett Designs on Facebook and Instagram for my jewelry, okay? Give me a follow over there. I always post pictures over there of what I'm working on and other things that you won't see on YouTube, okay? All right, guys. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And I'll catch you next time. Ciao!